Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you the difference between raster and vector graphics. And these two types of images are very, very common. We see both every day. And this is something that was really confusing to me as a new graphic designer because it just wasn't explained to us very well. Usually it was just Illustrator is for vector and Photoshop is for raster. But both of those programs can use both of those types of files. So first, let's go over what vectors are and what rasters are, and I'll give you some examples of each. We'll also go over file types of each. Now you might be wondering, well, why does it even matter? Why do I need to know this? Really, if you're not a graphic designer, you probably won't need to know this. But if you are, the type of file can really matter with the quality. For example, when I need a company's logo, I always ask for a vector. That way I can use it at any size. If I don't specify that information, they'll usually send me a really small JPEG, and then when I make it bigger, it gets all blurry. So let's tackle vectors first. Vectors are drawings made using anchor points and mathematical formulas, even though the person drawing them doesn't have to know those formulas or be good at math or anything like that. A few defining characteristics of these. If you zoom in really, really closely, the graphic will still look really clean. You can enlarge them as much as you want without them looking blurry or losing quality. Vectors usually end up as rasters, though, because vectors aren't supported in a lot of cases. So if you're in a program like Illustrator, which is the one I'm in right now, you can export your vector as a JPEG. A JPEG is a raster image that's accepted on most websites. When you're storing your files, you'll have a vector format, and you'll also have your raster formats like JPEG. SVG is a vector format that is now accepted on the web, so it's becoming more popular as a web graphic. Vector file sizes are usually really small because they just need to include the information for the paths and anchor points used to create them. Illustrator is a vector-based program, so most of the time if you use the tools in Illustrator over here to draw something like a logo, then that's going to be a vector image. Common file types for vector images are AI, SVG, EPS, and PDF. Raster graphics are made up of pixels. If we zoom in really, really close, we can start seeing these little pixels here. But if you have a very high resolution image, you won't see those pixels when you're just viewing it at full size. So here are a few things to know about rasters. As I said before, if you zoom in as much as possible, you're going to start seeing the individual pixels, which gives the appearance of blurriness. Photos, JPEGs, and PNG files are all raster graphics. So when you zoom in, you're going to see those. But if your resolution is high enough, you won't see them until you zoom in, of course, and your image will look crisp and clear like this one does. When you take a high resolution photo, that means there are more pixels in every inch, and that gives your photo a crisper look, but it also increases the file size. But even still, with the best, most crisp raster image, you can always still zoom in and start seeing the little pixels. Raster file sizes are a lot bigger, generally speaking, because the file has to hold all those tiny little pixels. Photoshop is a raster-based program, so when you're editing photos, most of the time you're working with raster images. Common file types for raster images are JPEG, PNG, and GIF. But there are tools in Photoshop, like the pen tool, that will allow you to create vector images inside Photoshop. The same goes for Illustrator. Illustrator does have some raster capabilities. So if raster images lose quality when you increase the size, why use them? Well, it's best to use them when you need something really detailed like photos. Also, most vectors have a cartoonish look like this. And while you can create photorealistic vectors, they're super time intensive. This image is not a photo. It is a photorealistic vector. So it looks very realistic. Once you zoom in, though, you can see that it's not a photo. This artist who created this image shows us his process. He first had to draw this image in Illustrator, and then he used the gradient mesh tool to get these really nice gradients on the skin and hair. I'm sure this took a long time to make. Another reason to use rasters is that on the web, raster images are standard. Although, as I said before, SVG files, which are vectors, are becoming more and more common for web graphics. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.